Yes, I'm a man with a pussy.
Here we go. The fabulous Mr. Buck Angel.
Once I was a girl named Susan, and now I'm a guy named Buck. I couldn't live as a woman anymore. I could not live that way. I wanted to kill myself every day that people interacted with me as a woman and looked at me at my face and said she. And I felt like this guy you see right here. And I was Susan, that girl you see in those pictures.
A successful fashion model at 17, beautiful to the world, but ugly in her own eyes.
I tried suicide and was put into a psychiatric institution for a while because of my suicide attempts. I can remember how sad and disconnected I was with life. I didn't really know that I was a transsexual person until way later on.
Buck started transitioning from woman to man at 28 through hormone therapy, a strict diet, and a pretty intense workout regime. He had his breasts cut off, but still didn't feel man enough.
I wanted a penis like, for me, a cisgendered or a biological man has. I wanted the functioning thing that I could use, and they didn't have that. That was sort of like the point where I realized that I don't have to have a penis. I don't have to have it. I don't have to have it to be a man. It's not necessary. It's a misconception completely.
But most people would argue that genitalia is what differentiates us, you know, as men and women. How can you truly be a man without a penis?
What makes a man and what makes a woman? It's sure not genitals. Because what if, let's say you lost your penis. Are you no longer a man? How I feel like a man is owning myself and loving myself.
And you don't even need a penis to make it as a male porn star. Buck Angel was the first transsexual man ever to penetrate the mainstream adult entertainment industry. The world's only porn actor of his kind, the man with a vagina, has produced and starred in award-winning hardcore scenes with straight men, gay men, and trans women, always playing the role of the man. But what about when the cameras aren't rolling?
It just really depends mostly on the person and that connection I have sexually, or I feel aroused, you know, I feel turned on by you. And it's not really whether or not you're a guy or a girl. I don't really care about that. And also I have to tell you that sex with a man is different for me than sex with a woman. I'm very attracted to guys who are muscular and very hyper-masculine. If I was gonna have, it would probably always be really rough. We'd probably have really punching kind of stuff like that. We'd have probably cigars. I'm very into cigar smoking and boots and fetishy kind of stuff like that. Hyper-masculine stuff like that. And if I was gonna probably have sex with a woman, I would say it's much more sort of kissing and sort of cuddling and not so necessarily hardcore that way.
Buck, let's talk relationships. You were married to a dominatrix who left you for Lana Wachowski, who was once Larry Wachowski, one half of the Wachowski brothers who made The Matrix. That must have been hard to swallow.
I've never even talked about it before because I just didn't feel it was necessary. So I was with my dominatrix wife, Ilsa Strix, Karen, and we were a married couple, but we were also a professional couple, and we had a dungeon in downtown Los Angeles, and she was a very well-known dominatrix and got a lot of high-profile clients, one of them being Larry Wachowski, who's now Lana Wachowski. And so through that, they started having an affair. They were filming The Matrix 3 here in Sydney during the time of the affair. And so he would fly her out here and she'd be here for like months and I'd be like, what's going on? And I pretty much cut it off. I said, it's either him or me. And so, you know, she couldn't make a choice. So I made a choice and filed for divorce.
Buck is now an author, trans activist and educator. In between porn films and live strip shows, he travels the world spreading this message.
I want to change the world. I want to make people think about what that means to be a man and a woman and a straight person and a gay person and understand that it doesn't exist. I want to deprogram people from thinking they have to be this way. That's my ultimate goal.
So this is a question I reckon a lot of people are going to want an answer to. When you go to piss, do you stand at the trough or do you go into the ladies' cubicle?
Right on. Love these questions. So, can I stand at the trough? And of course I can, but here's the deal. I have to take my pants all the way down to my ankles. So I'm all like 4-year-old. I was doing it the other night at this club. And I totally do it. I don't care. I completely take my pants down to my ankles and I stand against it all the way and I pee in it. But you know, it's that confidence. I'm telling you, it's about that self-love of yourself. When you have that and it radiates to the world, people don't feel the need to say mean things to you. Because I am so confident in being the man that I am.